Zombie apocalypse.
Okay, so this time let us apply no yung pinaka principle na diniscuss ko last in the video lecture that I have presented, no. Let us apply this first in a simply supported beam. So let's get ready to be neuroized. Suppose that we have this beam, no, loaded with a 4 kN per meter with a 4 meter width, which is measured 2 meters from A, and a 25 kN concentrated load that is located 2 meters from the roller support, given the flexural rigidity E modulus as 200 GPa and inertia as 1500 times 10 to the 6, so meaning the member is prismatic, or the element or the section, the cross section used is same value throughout from the span of the beam. Now we are to calculate slope at point C, A and C, then deflection at point C, and the maximum deflection. Okay. Now before we start analyzing this, so we have to, of course, visualize ano ba muna ang potential deflection ng beam natin. So note that usually if the beam is subjected for gravity loads, so the beam will deflect like this. So most likely if there's no effect of moment in externally applied, or an effect of an overhang, so most likely it won't be a double curve that I will try to discuss on the next video lecture, as we are going to apply that in a double overhang. So there will be only one possible case of deflection, so meaning a positive bending. So we are aware that the concavity that goes up, no, is a positive bending, and the concavity that goes down is a negative moment. Okay, so i-prove natin to mamaya kung ano talaga yung proof of, or the evidences of having this. Now, so most likely, if there is a question of slope at A, as on letter A, so I'll try to project a tangent line on A, okay, and a horizontal line at A, so this would be our theta sub A, okay? And also, as on point C, that we don't know what particular location is, let's say, I'll assume that C will be parang lumagpas na sa isang point of inflection na we can say as a maximum. So therefore, we can say that this is our theta C as an assumption, and there is a deflection at C. Okay, I'll just try to mark it in blue. Ayan. So yan yung value ng delta C from the original beam. And we don't know the location of the maximum deflection that we can assess based on, you know, based on the slope reading, and maybe based on the assumptions that you can do. Okay, so this is the potential beam bending that the beam will suffer from the applied load. So let's try to understand all of those possible situations. Okay, first things first, you have to identify if the beam is determinate and indeterminate. In the principle of double integration method, it is subdivided into two classification. Let's call it DIM, no, or double integration method. So there's a DIM application on a simply supported, or what we call, generically speaking, determinate beams, and there's also a separate application on an indeterminate beam that we already discussed before, on how do we classify if the beam is unstable, determinate, or indeterminate. It is so essential that the viewers or the learners already know how to categorize the type of beam, the truss, and the frame that we are going to analyze, and as well as how do we quantify it or qualify it based on its nature. So I strongly recommend to those who are viewers or learners that does not fully understand those principles, kindly go back to my video lecture that I already discussed with the title of statically indeterminacy issue, okay, or statically determination of the statically indeterminacy. Okay, now, so knowing that this is a simply supported, meaning this is a determinate, since the loads are not concurrent, the loads are not producing moment that will make the beam unstable, since there is a hinge and a roller support system, and also all supports are interacting or counteracting the resultant load. Okay, so therefore this is a determinate beam, and then if the beam is determinate, then we can calculate the reaction. So using statics, so I hope that the viewers and learners has their calculators during this viewing of this video lecture, so they will get the following. Okay, so if you want to get the reaction at A, the vertical one, so produce a moment at T equals 0, then you will get 162 over 11, and or you can take a moment at A or a moment, a summation forces vertical, so you can now get reaction at T as 289 over 11. So what's next? So we try to understand now the principle of a double integration method. So first things first, locate the leftmost part as discussed with my previous video lecture. So locating it, that is point A. So if pinakadulong kaliwa, wala namang overhang sa kaliwa para doon kayo mag-locate ng dulong kaliwa. Okay? So therefore, having A as our 0-0 coordinate and then following René Descartes' rule. Okay? So this is the y-axis, this is the x-axis, and then let this A as the 0-0 coordinate. I'll try to write that on the other side. Let's say in, using the violet marker. Okay? 0-0. And on B, there's a coordinate of 2-0, xy. The coordinate suggests before deformation or before deflection happens. And on C, we have 6. It's not 4 kasi taken from A ang ating coordinate system. So 4 plus 2 is 6, 0. Okay? 0 yung Y kasi hindi pa natin pinade-deflect. And D is a reading of 9 and 0. And for E, that is 11 and 0. Okay? Let me write this in clear view. Okay? 11, 0. Now, we try to live in the expectation of a beam deflection because in DIM, it's very important to analyze and visualize how will the beam will deflect. Now, I discussed earlier that the beam will potentially deflect like this, okay, due to the behavior of the load. So, this would one of the ends of analysis. But before that, let's try to come up with the understanding of the DIM, how to apply that. Next, after locating the leftmost part of the beam, is to locate the rightmost segment of the beam. It is segment DE. Put a cutting plane on that segment. The last cutting plane only. Okay? The last segment that should be cut. And then from 0-0 coordinate up to the last cutting, the cutting plane on the rightmost segment, that will be the designated distance X, the variable X. So, yung X ayan nagde-define kung paano magbe-behave yung beam natin as a function. Okay? And then you produce a moment. However, notice that there is a 0-degree load that does not touch the cutting plane, right? So therefore, there's a need for us to draw a reorientation of the geometry. So just like what I have discussed before, if the concentrated load 0-degree and or higher should be increasingly touching the cutting plane. But for the case of 0-degree, it is not increasing since there is a uniform slope of 0 value, 0 degree. So what you can do is just only extend it, okay? So therefore, there will be a full rectangular that goes down, and there is a missing area here, if you notice, okay? You just add the area that goes down. So therefore, you just add an area that goes up. So para i-mirror image nyo lang, kung ano yung dinagdag mo, siya din ibabawas mo sa baba. At ang load na nasa baba, laging pataas po ang kanyang intensity. So that you would understand it and also apply what you have learned already in your statics of rigid bodies discussion. Okay? So I hope it is clear that what we are going to do before we come up with a moment equation, since double integration method is highly dependent on the moment equation, then. So by visualization, what I need to do is to extend this 0-degree load. So therefore, what I'm going to come up is, let's say, this one. So this will be in full area of a 0-degree touching the cutting plane, okay, in question. And there should be a load that goes up, okay, by representation, okay, and that will be the same area that you should not be including since DIM requires to continue the load and should be increasingly touching the cutting plane. So therefore, that should be another area to look at that I'll try to color it green. Yan. So the question would be, what is the magnitude? Now, if the load is 0 degree, then we understand that it is of the same value, right? So therefore, that's 4 kilonewton that 4 kilonewton per meter that goes down. Then it is also 4 kilonewton per meter that goes up. So that's now ready for the moment equation writing. Okay, as we speak. Now, so that would be our EI y double prime. So for the EI y double prime, so tingnan niyo po maigay, the 162 over 11 will rotate with a distance of x perpendicular going to the cutting plane of clockwise rotation. Note that the cutting plane considers left cut since, you know, where is left and right, no? So left cut tayo na-consider, so clockwise should be positive and counterclockwise should be negative by ordinary sense. And there's also another one that will rotate positively, the 4 kN per meter that goes up, meaning the area is 4 times the width of x minus 6, okay? Because this distance is just only x minus 6, since there is a remaining distance of 6 here, okay? 4 plus 2 is 6. And then, a centroid distance of 1 half of x minus 6. So that's why we arrive to this, and then the full area that goes down, the same 4 times x minus 2, so the same condition, since this is an x minus 2, okay, distance, okay? It is clear that it is x minus 2, and then a centroid of 1 half of each distance. And then also don't forget that there's a concentrated load that will rotate 25 kilonewton, okay? That 25 kilonewton that will rotate counterclockwise, so negative, with a distance of x minus 9. The sense is, this so beneficial to use the coordinate system, kaya ginawa natin yan, kaya madali makita kung anong dapat ibawas. And then, you will, as after simplification, you will arrive to this equation of EI y double prime. And then what do we need to do is to eliminate the prime, so by doing the double integration, as the title suggests, as the topic suggests. So first order integration is you will arrive to this equation, but don't forget to introduce an arbitrary constant, say C sub 1, and again, integrating it once from the y prime equation, or you can say by integrating it twice from the moment equation, EI y double prime, then you will introduce C sub 1x plus C sub 2. So, of course, the equation will be looking like this, okay? A simple integration will do the job, okay? Notice that we have two arbitrary constants, C sub 1 and the C sub 2. We need to eliminate them. How do we eliminate them? So, we observe the supports. Okay. Now, in observation of the support, there's only two, A and E. Okay, notice that I told you before in the past video lecture that at A we are allowed to rotate while the displacement through this deflection, okay, won't be allowed. So slope is just only allowed, or simply say that y prime is allowed, but for the deflection there's no value, so say zero, okay? So, since it is not allowed, unless if the support are yielding, that I will try to discuss that in a separate video lecture. How about the support is a spring, let's say. So, viewing the condition, you can see that at x is 0, where his support is located, then y is 0. Now, upon application, notice that the equation with pointed parentheses suggests in mathematical meaning is if you apply a value inside and it turns out to be negative, don't use the actual value, okay? The negative value. It is automatically zero. So, therefore, let's say an x minus 6, let's say sample, if x is less than 6, so it will give us a negative value, then the inside phrase should be automatically zero. Do not use, let's say, if x is 2, then 2 minus 6 is negative 4 in an ordinary algebraic sense, but in this kind of situation, 2 minus 6 is zero since there's a pointed parenthesis. And another good logic is, don't forget that we already identify at point A the leftmost portion. So therefore, we cannot accept a distance of negative since we are aware before in Cartesian coordinate system that going to the right is positive x, going to the left is negative x. So therefore, if you set already the leftmost part to be the center of the Cartesian coordinate system in point A, so therefore, we do not have any segment of the span or the beam to be found on the left portion since it is already the leftmost portion. Okay, that's the very reason why it is fit to use that in the mathematical term to use a pointed parenthesis. Okay, so therefore, C2 is 0, why? In the EIY equation, if x is 0, this is 0, 0 minus 6 is 0 in our logical calculation, and 0 minus 2 is 0, 0 minus 9 is 0, of course, C1 times 0 is 0, then C2 is also 0 with the proper unit. So why is it kilonewton cubic meter? Now let's have a review. EIY double prime is an equation of kilonewton meter. We are integrating it as an independent variable of x since x is running. Okay, it is a variable in question. So dy over dx, where dy is a dependent variable and dx or x is the independent variable. We are making the strip of x to increase by 1. Okay, so therefore, C sub 1 will carry kilonewton square meter. Say, para isipin mo, may 1 dyan sa taas ng m. So 1 plus 1 is 2. As well as EIY is kilonewton cubic meter. So therefore, C2 carries a unit of kilonewton cubic meter, while C1 carries the kilonewton square meter unit. That's true, kasi ang C1 mo, kilonewton square meter times meter, so kilonewton cubic meter for the EIY. So observe dimensional analysis. Now, so C2 is set to be 0, so wala na tayong problema sa C2. Now, let's try to evaluate C1. Now, how to evaluate the other constant, no? So, you jump onto the next support. So, at x is 11 meters, y is 0. So, that's the reading. So, kasi at 11 meters, andun yung support system natin na roller from A, no? So, y is 0. Again, deflection is 0. Sa Hessian roller, tandaan po ninyo, ang deflection are both 0 unless the supports are yielding or may paggalaw na mentioned. Now, what you can do is to review the EIY prime equation, set it to 0. Again, x, 81 over 11 x squared is 0. And 11 minus 6, okay, is acceptable. No, 81 over 11 x squared is not 0 since x is 11. So all of these equations seems to be positive. Okay? You are to use them all since all of them will give you a positive value if x is 11. 11 minus 9 is 2. So calculate as 2. Then x minus 2 is where x is 11. So 11 minus 2 is 9. Positive. So, compute as 9 cube. And 9 minus 6 is positive 3. So, compute as 3 cube. And of course, x should be as in terms of 11. 11 squared is positive automatically. Then you will calculate C1. And then you will eventually get that C1 is a negative value of 6,733 over 33 kilonewton square meter. Observe proper units. So, upon evaluation of the C1, C2, we are now ready to calculate the slope at A, the slope at C, the delta C, and the delta maximum as asked by the problem. Okay, so let's start with the slope at A. So, how to find the slope at A? Locate slope at A, the point A, no? So, that is the location of at x 0, okay? Dito yun, no? Nakaalala niyo, ito yung 0, 0 coordinate natin kanina, okay? So, at x is 0, and then supplying all the given values, ganun na naman. So, this is 0, okay? So, this is another 0, 0. Bakit 0? Kasi 0 minus 2, 0 minus 6 is automatic a negative value. Then, ito will give us a 0 value inside the brace, as well as x minus 9. It is already 0. So, what's left here is the C sub 1. There's a value, okay? Where C sub 1 is negative 6733 over 33 kilonewton square meter. So therefore, that's the value for EI theta A. What does the negative slope suggest? Now, let us have a short review of our past knowledge in trigonometry. In Cartesian coordinate system, we know that it's a positive, positive, negative, and negative. Okay? We are aware that it's the first quadrant, the second quadrant, the third, and the fourth. Now, in tangent rule, where the slope is observed, you divide both sides. So, positive over positive giving us positive. Positive over negative is negative. Negative over negative is positive. And negative over positive and vice versa is negative. So, if you have a negative sign, then notice that the second and the fourth will give you the direction of the quadrants. Okay? But for positive tangent, it should be like a positive quadrant located on the first, on the third. The sense is that the location of the tangent line will define the positioning of the elastic curve. So therefore, having that sense and then removing the sign already, so That's kilonewton square meter, so we need to convert that into a newton square millimeter since the flexural rigidity is appreciable to be calculated in terms of megapascal and millimeters to the fourth. That's why in kilonewton square meter, we convert it into newton square millimeter. So we need 1,000 for newton, kilonewton to newton, and 1,000 squared for meter squared to millimeter squared, and 1,000 times 1,000 squared gives us 1,000 cube. So to make it newton square millimeter. So if you notice the unit above is newton square millimeter over the unit of a modulus of elasticity E is in terms of gigapascal. So I convert gigapascal into megapascal since 1 megapascal is 1 newton per square millimeter multiplied by the inertia already in terms of millimeters to the fourth. So you notice that millimeter to the fourth over millimeter squared is a millimeter square unit. And newton millimeter squared over newton millimeter squared is a unit for radians. Cancelled eh. Okay. So therefore, we will get theta sub a of 6.8010 times 10 to the negative 4 radians. And how do we know the quadrant? Note that the sign negative suggests a quadrant 2 and 4 location. Is it true? Let's take a look. If the beam will deflect like this and the beam bending, if that is a positioning of the elastic curve, and the tangent should be drawn like this. Okay? Now, is it true it located into the second and fourth based on reading? Yes. Because if you put a Cartesian coordinate system at A, it looks like this is the second and the fourth quadrant system. So, it is true. So, therefore, the beam will deflect like this. And ordinarily, there should be only one position for A since the beam will deflect in terms of positive bending or positive moment. So there's no way for A, for this kind of system, that A will become a first or third quadrant system since the beam will not deflect like this unless it suffers double curvature. Kung mangyari man, may epekto na yun ng overhang at saka ng deflection ng due to applied moment. Now, to find for the slope at C, ganun din gagawin natin, locate at C, where x is 6, no? Kasi ito yung coordinate 6 is 0, x is 0, I mean, x is 6 and y is 0. So, therefore, replacing that, so ganun ulit, ano kayo magiging 0 dito sa EIY prime? So, automatically, no, ito lang yata ang magsisiro, kasi x minus 9 is a negative 3 value where x is 6. But the rest will be calculated, kaya ito pinakita ko muna for the meantime. So you will get positive 60733 kilonewton square meter and doing the same dimensional analysis. So di ko na muna pinakita, but I think it is now the responsibility of the viewers or the learners to calculate since it is of the same conversion. Then you will get theta C of 6.1313 times 10 to the negative 5 radians. The sign is positive meaning already in the first and to the third quadrant. So simple to understand. This is positive, right? And positive, negative, negative. So, quadrant number 1 and quadrant number 3 is the location of the slope of positive. Okay? So, meaning, at point C, review lang natin. Yung A natin, no, nasa first and third. And on point C, umahon ang ibig sabihin natin dyan. Okay? Nasa first or third na, no? So, therefore, we can have an idea that medyo nilagpasan na yata yung pinaka lowest point. Okay? Bakit nasabi natin nilagpasan na? Kasi umahon bigla yung slope. So, para masabi natin na hindi pa nalalagpasan, let's say here, on this particular point, kunyari yan yung napuha, hindi pa lumalabas sa pagiging first or second, hindi pa nawawala sa pagiging second or fourth quadrant. So, pag naging second and fourth at naging sa isang point na inanalyze is first or third, meaning nalagpasan mo na yung possible lowest point, which is our understanding is that slope at zero, then that there should be a position for the maximum deflection. Okay, but let us try to understand that later. Now, next is to find out what is the deflection at point C. So, tandaan ulit natin na pag binidrawin natin yung beam at positive bending, kailangan makita natin yung delta C natin bumaba eh. Kasi load natin is pababa, no? Tingnan natin, dapat expectation natin ito, delta C mo negative. So at x is 6, you do the same, then you will get negative 2210 over 3 kilonewton cubic meter. So tama na nag-negative, and negative in the sense of deflection, dalawa lang yan at the y condition. Okay, ito yung positive, ito yung negative. Kapag negative, bumaba ang deflection. Kapag y mo is positive, then umangat yung deflection. So dahil bumaba, dahil negative, bumaba yan. Okay? So clear to understand. And then using the sense of dimension analysis, bakit 1,000 to the fourth yan? Kasi kilonewton cubic meter, yung EI delta C, no, dapat alam natin yung unit, already discussed earlier. So therefore, converting in terms of newton cubic millimeter, so meron kang 1,000 at saka 1,000 cube multiplier, kaya nag-arrive tayo sa 1,000 to the fourth. Again, the unit is newton cubic millimeter, at tapos sa denominator, no, newton square millimeter, yung katulad ng proving natin kanina. So notice that the resulting unit is just only millimeter, a distance unit, which is true. Then finally, you will get delta C of 221 over 90 mm that goes down, or in decimal form, that is 2.4556 millimeters downward. Now, the question would be, kung ito ba ang ating maximum deflection, dapat wala naman sa taas yan. But the question is, ito ba yon? No. Kaya meron pa sing mas lower point pa sa delta C that we need to find out. Kasi based on the reading, kasi kung ito yung totoong maximum deflection, then the slope should be zero. Don't forget that kanina ang theta C natin ay may value pa. Almost zero. Pero hindi pa rin totally zero. So let us find out for the maximum deflection. Now, before we proceed with the maximum deflection, then binigyan tayo ng traces on how to find it, or you can simply use your assumption. Okay? Pero gamitin natin yung scientific evidences na nakuha natin kanina. Before the theta A, we calculate on quadrant 2 and 4, while on point C, we calculate it on the first or to the third, tama. So therefore, somewhere here on B and C is maybe the location of the maximum deflection, and let's say it is a distance of x that we do not know right now. So we need to trace what is x, so that after we know what is x and then calculate inside the EIY equation, and then we will find out the EI delta max already. But the challenge is, what is the value of x? How do we qualify the distance x? Ganito po ang setup. Now, you have to introduce a binding condition where the most observed condition for maximum deflection is, of course, hindi nyo pwedeng baguhin ito. At y prime is 0, deflection is maximum. Kasi ito yung maximum minima condition ng calculus, if you recall. Now, in terms of its application, in terms of deflection, y prime is 0, y is deflection maximum, but what is x? So, you have to try a segment. So, by this analysis, I'll try segment BC. I'll base my assumption that I pass a cutting plane, parang ganun na nangyari, on BC. Now, the limiting distance from A, kasi doon lang nanggaling yung ating x distance, is from 2 to 6. Ano ang importansya ng 2 to 6 na yan? Yan ang magva-validate natin kung i-accept ba natin yung roots na makukuha natin, or may lado yung assumption, i-correct natin later. Now, notice that there is an inside phrases that we need to understand if negative 0 and positive 0. Note, the value resides between 2 to 6. Ibig sabihin, kapag ang value mo is in between 2 to 6, positive, accept the equation. And then if the value is negative, then do not put that into the equation of calculating x. So, hindi naman usually saktong 2 and 6 yung nakukuha dyan. So therefore, what's the trick of using the boundary is for you to assess the possible maximum outcome of the value of x, which is 6 meters. Kasi yung 2 na to, bihira mangyari na talaga sumaktong 2, might as well consider 6. But as an extreme limit to validate if the acceptable value is 6 and less than 6 but more than 2, then should be capable of being computed as inside the equation. Okay? Now, so using the trick here, no, at ito lang in mind, ano, but we are not sure if saktong 6. Use 6 inside, okay, tingnan nyo ha, at EIY prime, pasok mo dun, pasok mo dito, pasok mo dyan. Okay? If x is 6, automatic, this is 0. Okay? How much more if x is less than 6? So therefore, lalagyan 0 yan, right? Yun yung importansya niyan. Ngayon, pasok natin dito, 6 positive, eh, less than 6. Let's say if x is 5, positive, no? Positive pa rin yan. So, if x is 3, positive. Pero pag if x is 2, that is zero. Pero the sense is, hindi naman sasaktan to yan. So therefore, we can say that it is an acceptable equation. Okay? Kaya kung mapapansin nyo, nilagay natin dito yung x minus 2 phrase. While x minus 9, kahit yung 6 ang gamitin mo, negative. How much more is 6x mo? Pababa ng 6. So 5.5, 5.3, mag-negative yan. Kaya hindi natin i-accept yan. Okay, so ano meron lang dito? 81x squared, acceptable. This minus 2 third of x minus 2 cube, acceptable. And the C1 equation. That's why we arrive onto this equation. So ganun po ang selection procedure. Kaya ito po yung naging ganito. And then finally, you will calculate 3 kasi x na value, 3, kasi cubic, no? So, out of the 3, we cannot accept negative distance. If you recall, we cannot accept 14.8 and 16 kasi more than the span of 11 meters. Okay? So, this is not applicable. Then, if is 5.6744 meters acceptable, yes, it is in between 2 to 6. Okay? So, accept na natin yan. Eh, what if hindi siya acceptable? Let's say, nag-assume ka ng A, pero nakuha mong support is more than 2 meters, yung x. So, therefore, bibigyan ka niya ng idea kung saan mo siya hahanapin at i-correct mo yung calculation. I'll try to discuss that to you in our next video lecture na sasadyain ko namang what if hindi naman tumama yung aking assumption or what you are going to do. Ngayon, bakit tumama yung assumption ko? It is clearly observed that in theta sub A and in theta sub C, it already tells us that the location of maximum deflection is in between A and C. But most likely, it should be in BC since AB is medyo pababa pa lang by, of course, mere logic. So therefore, for the meantime, my assumption is correct. But however, next video lecture, I'll try to discuss what if the assumptions are not correct and how do you produce remedies out of that. And then noting that at x is 0.6744 is the location of the maximum deflection. Okay? So with that reasoning, we will now try to calculate the deflection maximum by substituting at x is 5.6744. So, meaning madali mo na ma-identify yung magka-qualify. Okay? So, ano yung magka-qualify dito? Kung ano yung ginamit mo sa slope, siya din yung pupunta sa y. So, ito, qualified. Okay? Ito, qualified. And C1 is qualified. Kasi tinan nyo, tumama yung assumption natin, no? Pag sinalpa ko yan dito, sinalpa ko yan dyan, magsisiro yan. Okay? So, kaya ito, nag-zero din ito, tsaka nag-zero din ito sa ating equation kanina on finding x. So, therefore, the calculation is now produced. So, you will get EI delta max of negative 739.6626 kilonewton cubic meter. Again, doing the same maneuver of dimensional analysis, you will get 2.4655 mm that goes down. Again, why it goes down? The negative sign suggests already the nature of deflection, and then you will notice that this is more than delta C for about 2.45. So, mas malaki pa rin yung delta max na nakuha natin na 2.4655 mm that goes down. So, meaning, totoo na ito ay bumaba. So, all of the units and conditions are met and they jive to the system of coordinate system, then we can conclude that the double integration method satisfies all the principles as discussed. So, thanks for viewing. I hope you learned something new today. And as our tradition, you have been neuroized and see you in our next video lecture. Coming up next is a discussion of double integration method where you're going to observe double curvature so that it would be complete for us to understand how does the beam behaves if the beam is happening from double curvature, but let us use double integration method for the first time. Okay, and then see you in our next video lecture.